Hi there, this is James Heideman. Welcome to another edition of Hey James, How Do I? And today we're going to talk about the DSO Nano oscilloscope, little pocket oscilloscope. I've been working with some electronics recently and I'm very, very new to electronics. I knew I needed an oscilloscope and this little guy was about £45, call that $60-$70, something like that. Seemed like an amazing bargain, so I sent off for one. And there's good news and bad news. The good news is that from a hardware point of view, it's a really cool piece of kit. The bad news is that the firmware that's on it, the software, firmware as they call it, is not that brilliant. Also, the manual that came with it, we'll look at this in a bit more detail in a minute, is for version 1.0b. And what I've got here, I eventually discovered, is version 1.5c. And it's not a version 2, but it is a DSO 200, so the manual doesn't relate very much to this. And as a complete and utter newbie, I couldn't make head nor sense or tail of it. However, the good news is that a wonderful man called Ben F, has completely rewritten the firmware. So what I'm going to put together here is a little video introducing you to the DSO Nano, showing you how to upgrade the firmware on yours, telling you what the differences are, and just get you started with the basics of how to use an oscilloscope, a very, very simple oscilloscope, because most of that how do you use an oscilloscope lessons on the internet are for big expensive oscilloscopes, not little cheap ones like this. Okay, continuing the tour around the DSO Nano, What I read about on the internet is that it says that it comes in pieces with a spare back and a battery that you have to install. Well, mine didn't. It just came perfectly complete like this. It came with a nice little carry case to put it in. It came with the probe, as I've already mentioned, and a USB connection. Quickly looking around, the switch on the top switches it on. Just pull it over like that. And it switches on. A bit difficult to see because it's too bright in here. I'll re-video this somewhere a bit darker. And then there's the signal out on the corner where you attach the probe with the BNC connector. Here is where you put a micro SD card, and that's where you connect it to USB. And that's pretty much it. Now, I mentioned the Ben F firmware. And I can tell you that the best thing you can do with your DSO is to install the new Ben firmware.